Hi everyone, I'm going to talk about dysmenorrhea and its management through acupuncture. Dysmenorrhea, the word itself refers difficulty during menstruation, or otherwise it is known as painful menstruation. In dysmenorrhea, there are two types. One is primary dysmenorrhea, another one is secondary dysmenorrhea. Primary dysmenorrhea is nothing but there are no underlying causes. Only pain during menstrual cycle, which disturbs person's day-to-day activities. The secondary dysmenorrhea is mainly due to any underlying causes. It may be in the uterus or maybe in the ovary. So in the uterus, especially like fibroid uterus, endometriosis or adenomyosis or several other pathological causes. So what are the criteria to diagnose dysmenorrhea? The initial onset of dysmenorrhea is usually 6 to 12 months after menarche with the onset of ovulatory cycles. Lower abdominal pain or pelvic pain often occurs for 8 to 72 hours, and it is usually associated with onset of menstrual flow. The other symptoms associated are back and pain in the thigh region, headache, diarrhea, nausea and vomiting, and also restlessness and irritation. Now coming to the management. So before going to the treatment, one has to identify what is the main cause for dysmenorrhea. So since there are no structural damage, it is purely functional. The spasm, that the blood flow will be reduced. The cause, when we analyze, one of the important factor may be stress, and second thing is lack of exercise, third one is poor dietary habits. So totally we can consider the irregular lifestyle or the unhealthy lifestyle is the main cause for dysmenorrhea. To young girls, one important note is the junk food, especially which is added with monosodium glutamate, or it is otherwise taste maker or taste powder, which really has lot of adverse effect on our health, and it really destroys all the antioxidants which are very much helpful to control the inflammation in our body and also to manage many of the painful conditions. So to look at the TCM diagnosis, the stagnation or excess stagnation is the main cause, which is not moving, the energy is not moving to the other part, is the main cause for dysmenorrhea. More the differentiating factors are, if there is chi stagnation, more distension than pain, bloating, breast tenderness, stuffy chest, belching, irritability, short temper. When we look at the tongue, purplish and thin white coated tongue can be identified. Pulse will be wiry. The treatment points are, especially we can concentrate on the liver meridian. Liver 2 and 3 are the important points to move the liver qi, which are located, liver 3 is located 2 chun proximal to the first web space, and liver 2 is located 0.5 chun above the first web space on the 2. CV6, which helps to tonify the energy or qi, and especially affect the lower abdomen. Especially in dysmenorrhea, there will be typical pain on the lower abdomen, crampy type of pain. So to move that, we have to pierce 1.5 chun below the center of the umbilicus on the anterior midline. CV3, 4 chun below the center of the umbilicus on the anterior midline. GB34, gallbladder 34, with liver 2 and 3, move the energy in the liver and gallbladder channel, which is located on the anterolateral aspect of the leg. Anterior inferior to the head of the fibula. Spleen 8, which is again helps to move the qi, and it is a specific point for dysmenorrhea. which is located 3 chun distal to the medial side of the knee joint. Spleen 10, 2 chun above the superior border of the patella on the anterior medial aspect of the leg. Spleen 6, which is one of the important distal point for urogenital organ. So any dysregularities in the urogenital function, spleen 6 is very much helpful to regulate the functions, which is located 3 chun above the tip of the medial malleolus, and UB32 on the sacral region, because dysmenorrhea is also associated with pain in the sacral region. Next point is blood stagnation, again excess condition. So here less distension effect with more pain with stabbing type of quality, and there won't be any tenderness in the breast. Abdominal pain will worsen with pressure, and there will be also blood clots. Tongue, which looks purplish or purple spots, will usually appear on the sides, very thin coated. Pulse will be deep, choppy, and can also maybe little wiry. The management is to resolve the blood stagnation. The points are stomach 29, which is on the abdomen, to move the blood stagnation from the abdomen. CV6 to move the blood stagnation in the abdomen. Spleen 6 again, which moves the energy towards down, blood downwards. Spleen 10, which helps to move the blood and chi. Liver 3, that is, and spleen 6 helps to move the chi in the lower abdomen. The next point is accumulation of cold, that is again excess of condition. Pain that is better with the application of heat and pressure. Scanty menstrual flow, dark blood with clots, tongue will be looked white coated, pulse will be deep and it will be tight. The treatment helps to disperse the cold, dissolve the stagnation. The points are CV4, which is helping to tonify the chi, warm and move the abdomen. Stomach 28, which helps again to give the warming effect since there is cold. Stomach 36, that is mainly to tonify chi and blood. Next point is liver and kidney deficient, that is called as deficient condition. So here the nature of the pain will be dull or intermittent. Pain of the lower abdomen, which arises during or after the menstruation, sore or mild aching pain. It is associated with the dizziness, chronic fatigueness and shallow complexion, or the person may feel pale. Tongue is light red, thin white coated, flabby tongue. Pulse is deep, fine, or it may be thin nature. So the management principle is tonify the liver and kidney, move the chi in the Chong Mai and Ren Mai channels. The points which are used are UB18, which is the Shu point for liver, UB23 Shu point for back, Shu point for kidney, CV4, which is used tonify and warm and move the abdomen, kidney 3 again helps to tonify the kidney chi, stomach 36 tonify the chi and blood, liver 3 or liver 8 helps to move the chi in the lower abdomen. Another point which is commonly observed here is blood deficiency. Here, dull pain after menstruation, dizziness, palpitation, scanty menstruation. Tongue will be observed as pale with thin moss or slightly peeled. Pulse is empty and thin. The purpose of management is tonify the blood, move the chi. Points are UB18, again liver back shoe point, UB20, which is the back shoe point for spleen, UB23, back shoe point for kidney, spleen 6 to tonify spleen and blood, spleen 10 again to tonify and move the blood, liver 8, nourish the liver and especially to affect the lower warmer. So hence, during the menstrual pain, instead of going for the medications, that is analgesics, which gives you temporary effect, we have to correct the lifestyle and use the simple remedies like acupuncture, some of the acupressures. You can consult the acupuncturist and to have some simple home remedies, and also you can take the easy treatment like hot water fermentation over the abdomen, which will definitely give you a better relief. Thank you.